remember 9/11? I do. I know exactly where I was when that happened. That burst this whole headache right here that we're about to talk about for everybody that's buying a house, especially for somebody that's receiving cash from somewhere or that's self-employed. This can be a problem, and it's better to know about it ahead of time so you can start doing the things that won't make you have to be scrutinied. So, number one is the United States Patriot Act says that all money that's being used in a mortgage loan as down payment money or reserves that enter that borrower's bank statement have to have a paper trail for 60 days from a bank account. So if you're moving money or you're depositing cash, it has to have a 60-day paper trail. Well, cash doesn't have a paper trail. So the whole point of this law was to find terrorists who are laundering money through real estate transactions. It's not to make my life miserable. God knows it sometimes does. Or your life miserable as a borrower, is to find the bad guys because they like to use real estate to hide large sums of money. So a couple things to don't do, don't deposit cash. It just makes for a nightmare because what happens when the cash goes in, it's like pouring water into a glass that already has water in it. You can't back out the water that was already put in because we don't know which water was which. We can't tell which money is which. So an underwriter's solution is they just back out an equivalent amount of money that was deposited because they can't say which money that you actually spent because money is liquid. So don't deposit cash. Number two, this is a big one, is gift funds that come from a family member or a friend that's helping you buy the house have to have a paper trail. And the paper trail is two things. Number one, it's the check that they gave you to deposit the money. Number two, and this is where the kind of problem can come in, is we have to get their bank statement to show that they had the money before they gave it to you. And a lot of times, if you prepare them ahead of time that, hey, if you're going to give me money, I'm going to need your bank statement. And you can tell them this, I need to give the bank statement to John and his team. That way you as the borrower don't know how much money your friend or family member have. That's usually what their concern is. We don't really care where they spend their money. We just care that the money that they gave you was legitimately theirs for 60 days before they gave it to you. Hope this helps. We get this question a ton. Why do I have to give my bank statements? Why does somebody else? Why can't I deposit cash? Everything has to have a paper trail. So sorry about that, but it's a federal law. Thank you so much.